chassis for my Reliant engined race cars. This is the later type gearbox, which is not the type that's fitted to my car. This has got an all synchro mesh gearbox, which would be nice, but I'll be sticking with the three synchro mesh version in the meantime. The stock gear ratios in these are probably not quite as good for the hill climbs and sprints, especially on first and second gears. They're a little bit taller gear. Whereas this is the three synchro version. A slightly different fittings at the clutch spindle. This is a clutch spindle that goes right the way through. Whereas this has got a little pivot in there that comes in from one side. And different gear shift patterns as well. This is versus a lift across and back. This one is a lift and a cross and forward to the left. The gearbox in my Hamblin is like this one, except the reverse is on the opposite side. The gear shift lifts across and back to the left, which is not one I've seen before. So there must be at least three different patterns. Anyway, these are my spare gearboxes. I'm about to go and take the gearbox out of the Jeffrey to check the gear ratios in that, because I've suspect it's got a long first and second gear fitted for circuit racing, but I'm not 100% certain. Could just be the engine's not very powerful and I'm not accelerating rapidly. But I shall need to get it out anyway, because the clutch has been making some funny noises after Bone S last year. But, I have various other bits of clutch lying about, but diaphragm type clutch covers which I might try on it. I managed to find a couple of them that should fit the 6 1/4 clutch driven plate. But I'll need to take the other clutch out and see if there are any broken springs. This is the installation in the Jeffrey. The gearbox is sitting in here. It's got the extension out to the cockpit with the gear lever. But it can come out with the engine in situ. It just takes a bit of jiggling about and rotating, and it does come out through the hole. But I've got to take a few other bits off. They give me clearance to get it out. Obviously get the prop shaft off, hold the wiring, take out the clutch actuating lever, which involves taking out part of the pedal assembly. It's not as drastic as it sounds, but an awful lot of screws to take out. Tripping over things here. So I'm first going to remove my seat and the transmission tunnel to give me some access. I also need to adjust the transmission tunnel at the back again. It's still not got enough clearance against the rear prop shaft flange, which rubs on extreme cornering. I slowly chiselled bits away from it last year, but it was still making an unholy noise on certain corners, so I shall need to fix that once and for all. I've got all the bolts out, starter motors off, prop shafts off, gear mounts off, all the earth cables are off, so it should just it's just getting the clutch
sleeve around. Gearbox. What's the crack like? Yeah, it could be the springs on the box release arms or rattle a bit. And there's no load on it. I think it's just the design of the clutch cover that causes that. Anyway, I think I'll try a diaphragm clutch on it. Do away with all this springing mechanism. That still goes round and round. Right, I need to check the gear ratios in my gearbox now. Well, there's part of the problem. The graphite insert in the clutch release bearing has shattered. The face is all smashed away, all powdered in the bottom. I must have been abusing it slightly. That'll definitely need to be replaced. I don't know if it's possible to fit a later bearing type one. I'll need to have a look and see what we've got. And that is a later bearing type one, but totally different. Wonder if I can modify something to put a bearing in there. Because that's not good. Anyway, that could certainly account for some of the tinkling noises I was hearing. So the next thing to do is try and figure out what gear ratios it's got. Right, I've got my chart of gears, the expected ones. For a Reliant Regal up to 1973, it should be 4.272 to 1. I was getting about 2.7. Yeah, about 2.7 to 1 on 1. Double check that. Yep, 2.7 to 1. Let's see what setting is. Set this back up to 0 again. Clean off the marks. About 1.6. Let's see here. That should be third. About 1.2. top should be
for the very top here.
That's top. That should be 1:1. It can't really be anything else. Unless it's a broken shaft. Yeah, obviously 1:1. Right, well, it's definitely got a very high first and second gear, so it must be a nice set of close ratio clusters with a high first and second, because what I was expecting in this gearbox was 4.27 and I'm getting 2.7 for first gear. For second gear, expecting 2.459, I'm getting 1.6. Third, I was expecting 1.45, I'm getting 1.2. Yes, I think I shall probably put in the gearbox over there that's got the Regal ratios in it, and that will certainly be better for hill climbing. That will definitely explain the slow acceleration and the fact I was not getting out of second gear up Bowness. I think it changed down to first gear for the hairpins, which is not nice in a non-synchromesh first. Probably explains a lot of the shattered clutch parts. So I shall put a diaphragm clutch in, clutch cover in, gearbox with the different ratios in it, and that should help immensely. And I'll need to figure out a better clutch release mechanism. I would have to change far too many things if I went for the fully synchro box. Plus the gear ratios aren't quite as good there. 3.88 as opposed to 4.27 for first, 2.05 instead of 2.45, and 1.32 instead of 1.45. So yes, I think we will go with the Regal. Because at 7,500 revs, I'd be getting 22 mph in first, 39 in second, 66 in third, 96 in fourth, and that's only at 7,500. It'll rev a wee bit higher than that. But yes, I think we'll do that.